Hey everyone, I'm building an entire first-person shooter game from scratch in the Godot engine and documenting the progress with these tutorials. In this video, we're setting up a dynamic crosshair similar to what you see in games like Call of Duty. The basic FPS controller project from episode 1 is available for free on GitHub, and if you would like to use the written version of this tutorial or download all of the source files, you can get access by joining my Patreon. Let's dive in. The crosshair or reticle will be set up within our player controller's scene. Eventually this and other UI nodes will probably go into its own scene, but for now we're just going to house everything in our controller. We'll be using a couple of control nodes to set up our layout and center our crosshair on the screen. Your setup will look like this. The user interface node is a control node that will act as our parent node. After you add it to your scene, you're going to make two changes in the inspector. First, under Layout, change the Anchors preset to Full Rect, or Full Rectangle. This will stretch the size of our control node to the full size of our screen. It also means it will automatically adjust itself if we change our screen size. Next, under Mouse, change Filter to Pass. This will be set to Stop by default, which will cause us to lose mouse interactivity, and we won't be able to move our camera, which is no good. Setting it to Pass will keep the mouse free. The next node, called Reticle, is a center container node and is a child of your user interface node. Reticle will hold our script for our crosshair and center it on our screen. You'll need two changes to the node settings. Under Layout, change Layout Mode to Anchors and Anchors Preset to Center. This will keep the node and all of its children centered on the screen. First, we'll add our crosshair dot that will represent the very center of our screen and where the player is aiming. Add a new script to the reticle node named reticle. In the script, you'll need two export variables, dot radius with a default of 1 and dot color set to white. These represent the size and color of our dot. Then add a function named draw. It should be named this exactly as you're overriding an existing function. Then use the draw_circle function to create our dot. This function needs the position for the dot. We're using absolute center here, so 0, 0. Then the radius of our circle, we're using our dot radius setting. And finally, the color, or our dot color. Then in your ready function, add q_redraw. This function tells the node to redraw any draw commands that you've put into your script. Run your scene, and you should now see a small dot in the center of your screen. For our Call of Duty-inspired four-line crosshair, we're going to be using four Line2D nodes as children of our reticle node. Top, right, bottom, and left. One of Godot's strengths is the ability to easily mix 2D and 3D, and these Line2D nodes will load up right on top of our screen. Now, could you just place an image of a crosshair here? Absolutely. But it's going to be really difficult to manipulate or have it react to your gameplay. These four lines will allow us to adjust our crosshair's shape, size, color, position easily through scripting. We need to set up each line by adding two points. For our top line, add two elements or points to our point array with these values. Then change the width of our line to 2 pixels. You should see a line in the center of your 2D play area. Repeat those steps for the remaining lines using the following point coordinates, and feel free to adjust the length or size of the lines for your game. You should now be able to run your scene and see your new dynamic crosshair in the center of your screen. All right, guys, if this tutorial was helpful, consider it a like and subscribe to the channel, as we're going to be covering a lot more. Thanks to all of my patrons who keep this series going. You too can get access to the written tutorials and the project source files by joining my Patreon. You can download everything there, and you'll also get early access to my videos and sneak peeks at future tutorials. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep creating.